Georgia.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. And I would remind this whole body that it is more than eight lines. In fact, there's four facts. There's no pressure. There's no conditionality. They did nothing to get it, and they got the money. With that, I yield a minute and a half to the gentleman from Florida, Mr. Spano.
Gentleman's recognized.
I rise in opposition to this political effort to remove President Trump from office. I'm not surprised this day has come, but I am disappointed. Disappointed because impeachment is one of the most consequential decisions that we can make in this body. And this impeachment is based purely on partisan motives. Speaker Pelosi said we shouldn't go down this path unless there was something compelling, overwhelming, and bipartisan because of how divisive it would be. Unfortunately, it's clear the majority has had laser focus on one thing for 3 years, impeaching the president. The majority has failed to deliver for the American people. They failed to pass a budget on time, failed to pass the spending bills on time, and failed to deliver bipartisan solutions that will actually help improve the lives of Americans. But the American people see through this sad charade for what it is, an attempt to undo the 2016 election based on hearsay and opinion, not fact. The transcript of the call showed no conditions were placed on the aid. President Trump and Zelensky have said there was no pressure and Ukraine received the aid without taking any actions. The Constitution is clear. The president may only be impeached for committing treason, bribery, or other high crimes and misdemeanors. Nowhere in the two articles of impeachment brought today does it argue that the president has committed treason, bribery, or any crime under the law. This is not overwhelming. It is not compelling. It is not bipartisan. But the speaker has right. She was right in one way. This is incredibly divisive and has lowered the bar for what future presidents will face. I strongly oppose the articles before us today, and I hope that we will finally move past this nightmare and get to work to deliver results for the American people.